All right, thank you, Brian. Happening right now, the Colonial Pipeline shutdown is entering day six, and a state of emergency is still in effect here in North Carolina. The pipeline is a primary source of fuel for most of the East Coast. This is video from this morning at the Speedway gas station on University Parkway in Winston-Salem. Employees say they shut the pumps off last night to save for a morning rush. Gas Buddies reporting 16% of gas stations across the state are out of gas this morning. The White House says Colonial should decide today if its cyber defenses are good enough to get back to work without the attacks spreading. The director of public affairs for AAA Carolinas acknowledges this is happening while people are already in a high state of panic.
You're already in a heightened state of panic. So you think about us being, you know, we're dealing with the pandemic, and, you know, when we were dealing with, I'm not going to have enough toilet paper, I'm not going to have enough disinfectant, I'm not going to have enough hand sanitizer, I'm not going to be able to go and find masks. So what did we do? We overbought then. We were in panic mode. So I think now add to that fuel, you know, and I think what you're having is even a more heightened state, you know, with us as motorists.
North Carolina's price gouging law is now in effect. There's no strict definition of the difference between price gouging and a business reacting to increased cost of stocking an in-demand item. Attorney General Josh Stein does say it's illegal to profit off a state of emergency.
North Carolina, the law says an unreasonably excessive price increase. And so there's not a specific dollar figure. If something increases a dramatic amount in a short period of time, and you're concerned, let my office know and we can look into it. It's entirely possible that that price increase was entirely because the cost of supply had increased to the gas station.
And if you think you've seen an example of price gouging and want to file a report with the AG's office, you can find out how to do so on WXII12.com.